Welcome to this step-by-step tutorial on how to enter planning data in Workforce. Workforce provides an application framework for collaboration across departments to plan headcount and personnel-related expenses such as salary, benefits, bonuses, and taxes. You can leverage from out-of-the-box content based on best practices such as drivers, calculations, and dashboards. Review your workforce data at a high level to gain a better understanding of key information, such as the mix of new and existing employees in your plan, a comparison of actual and plan headcount data, and the mix of compensation data, including taxes, benefits, and salary. Plan for new jobs. You can work within a wizard to add a requisition for a new job. Enter the information about the new job. Let's manage information for our existing employees. On this page, you can see employees, their current job assignments, and information about each employee. You can change some information for employees. For example, you can transfer them to another department, you can change their job assignment, or you can plan for their departure. Let's transfer an employee. If you have access to both the department that the employee is currently in, and the department that the employee is moving to, then you can transfer using a single action. Let's change a job assignment. You enter the new job and verify or change other information, such as the hours per week and FTE. When employees leave your organization, you can plan for their departure. You have the flexibility to indicate the reason for the departure. You can review and modify employee information on the Employee Details page. You can also see individual compensation details for this employee. You can view a summary of non-compensation expenses categorized by job in the top part of this dashboard. In the bottom part of the dashboard, you can review non-compensation expenses by the other expense categories that you define. You can enter non-compensation expenses by employee and job. On the Enter Expenses page, you can select an employee and job and enter data for the non-compensation expenses. Alternatively, you can select a non-compensation account and enter data for all the employees and jobs per entity. For those who have access, you can configure features enabled for Workforce. First, you import options, such as specific benefits and taxes, and then you can configure them. Let's configure fringe benefits. Within Benefits and Taxes, select Fringe Benefit Rate. For this benefit, we can set a component type. If Financials is enabled, we can select a financial account to map data from Workforce to Financials. Next, select how this benefit is calculated. There are several choices for payment terms. For the monthly, quarterly, and annual options, you can calculate expenses for either the fiscal or calendar year. I will select monthly, calendar year. Let's take a look at the options for value type. In this case, I will select percentage of salary. This is not a taxable component. Now we can enter some fringe rates. Here is an example of labor rate assumptions and their salary basis, such as annual, weekly, or hourly. In order to properly calculate salary from these rates, global assumptions are used. Global assumptions drive the calculations for salary expenses. Salary, additional earnings, benefits, and taxes are calculated based on the assumptions that you define. Let's take a look at the default for benefits. Some defaults apply to all jobs and all union codes, while others apply for a specific combination of job and union code. Let's assign a new default for all jobs. We want to apply a fringe benefit for all jobs and all union codes. The same concept applies to the other three components, salary, additional earnings, and taxes. You can specify that a benefit is available for specific jobs and union codes. For example, a car allowance may only be available for sales managers with no union code. In this tutorial, you saw how to enter planning data in Workforce for Enterprise Planning Cloud. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.